Before sharing with you this issue, I want to read to you this text message. The text message was sent to me again by someone who is close to me, a Swahili speaking person. And I have nothing against Swahili speaking people, but a lot of times the deen of the Swahiliyin has a lot of khurafat in it, a lot of shirk and bid'ah in it. Not all of them, but this is a common trait from that part of the world. This text message says to me, and you may have received it, when you carry the Quran, shaitan, he has a headache. And when you open up the Quran, shaitan, he collapses and he falls to the ground. And when he sees you reading the Quran, shaitan, he loses consciousness and he faints. So let's read the Quran as much as possible every time, so that we can keep shaitan fainting. And maybe one day he'll have a stroke and he'll never wake up at all. And did you also know that when you're about to forward this message, the shaitan will discourage you and tell you not to send it, but forward it anyway, and don't let him stop you. Ameen. Now, if you get up and you leave this majlis and you don't remember anything from the dars, one of the reasons why I read this to you is because we want our community to stop sending messages out like this. This opportunity is an opportunity to give the people who are here a dhikr. When you receive these types of text messages, you have to ask yourself before you are quick to send it off to the next person, is this stuff established in the religion? And where is the proof of this? We know reading the Quran is important, and we know that the shaitan doesn't like the dhikr of Allah, generally speaking, and he definitely doesn't love for the people to read the Quran. And we know that he flees from the house in which Surah Al-Baqarah is read in it. We know all of that. But when we start reading issues, shaitan, he gets a headache. Shaitan, he faints. Shaitan, he catches a stroke. Shaitan, he catches a heart attack. He has asthma, and on and on and on. These issues, the Muslim has to say, where did this come from? This is not our religion. So Ummat al-Islam, our religion, what's the point? What's the connection of this to Asia? The point is, we have to be a group of people who become diligent, serious, and we have to be on top of what we allow to go into our minds, and we call it our religion, what we believe in and what we don't believe in. Stop sending those text messages that you don't know where they came from and you don't know what they mean. It's not from our deen.